Just arrived near the entrance of Simien Mountains National Park in the Ethiopian highlands, also known as the Roof of Africa, home to some of Africa's highest peaks and most stunning scenery. And here behind me already we see a large troop of
endemic gelada baboons.
They're also called the red-hearted baboons, and I saw the alpha go past.
So let's go find the alpha. Getting a nice grooming from one of the ladies.
Day one on the Simien Mountain trek. We're with armed escort, I think just in case. I don't think it's dangerous here, pretty peaceful. Just passing some patches of namesake Abyssinian roses on our way from San Kader to Boise.
Yeah.
That's where we're going?
Yeah.
Thank you, guide.
Thank you, guide,
yes. The Simien Mountains are home to 30 endemic species. Ethiopia in its entirety has 5,500 endemic species.
It's really a land unique for its diverse habitats and peoples.
Made it to the Jinbar waterfall, one of the iconic sites. Unfortunately, the flow is not too strong right now because it's a dry street season. It's really a trade-off if you want to come when the weather's sunny all the time, or if you want to see some of the rivers and waterfalls at their prime best. Day two here. We left San Kader camp around 7:15 a.m. at 3,250 meters. We're on our way to Geech camp at 3,620 meters. just short of 300 meters elevation, because we're going mainly flat along the high plateau here. And it's a beautiful morning. Woke up to see a small herd of walia ibex grazing outside our campsite, and it's just a real pleasure to be here. Got about 15 kilometers to go today.
7:30 a.m. heading from San Calder camp to Geech. We're crossing through some highland brush forest here, and it's a beautiful fresh morning. It's got close to zero overnight, and it's warming up quickly. Feels amazing, exhilarating to be here right now.
Just Matt, what's your name?
Petros.
Petros.
Hi.
And are you from this beautiful land, Petros? Where are your origins?
Originally I am, yeah, but I live in Amsterdam, Holland, so I'm here as a visitor, as a tourist.
And how does it feel to be back here?
It feels nice. I mean, look at the views.
Speak to the microphone.
It feels nice. Look at the views.
Yeah.
Hi.
Perfect. Thank you very much. Don't you please? You have something
I would
else to say
recommend
to the world? What's your message to the world?
Yeah, I mean, come and see this beautiful place.
The Simien Mountains are home to 30 endemic species. Ethiopia, in its entirety,
has 5,500 endemic species. There are more than 80 different ethnic groups within Ethiopia, with the Oromo, Amhara, Somali, and Tigrayans making up more than 3/4 of the population. Political coexistence between groups has been challenging. The country lost its Red Sea coast in 1990 when Eritrea separated from Ethiopia after a 12-year war.
Magal.
Nice to meet you.
So I discovered that what we saw this morning was not the walia ibex yet. It was Menelik antelope, another endemic species
here in the Ethiopian highlands. And there below is a troop of Gelada baboons down at the water source.
So we just climbed down into a deep gorge past a troop of literally hundreds of gelada monkeys. This oasis here apparently is good to swim in. It's going to be chilly, but I'm going to give her a jump. Apparently it's deep enough. Let's see how it goes. One's for Wim Hof, the Iceman.
Woo! That's how Wim Hof is it.
Oh, I'm good.
Stay in there.
I know.
At least 3 minutes.
You would be disappointed in me if I didn't stay in. Okay. Nearing thermogenesis now. All right.
Oh, this is good. Okay.
Now you can cut it so they don't see me swim out fast.
So I found the endemic white crowned crow in the open highlands, and he's got a great perch, so let's take a look at him right now. Oh, darling. Look, he came over to say hello to us. And obviously very used to people in the campsites. Hey, buddy. You know there's food around. Don't you, buddy? It's beautiful. It's been a long day, about 8 hours, and just coming out of the petrified forest here, about 3,600 meters, 20 meters elevation. And about 20 minutes to go till we get to Geech camp. And it's one step after another now. We're gonna get there. Well, we made it to Geech camp at 3620 meters, and I've just hiked, I'd say another 300 or 400 meters at least. Should be around 4,000. Complete solitude up here, except for the squawk or chirp of the odd bird or rodent. Apparently, Ethiopian jackals inhabit these parts, and oh my goodness, what a view! So here we've come to the place called Gadada, meaning hole in the mountain. It's believed to be a sacred place for Ethiopian highlanders from before Christian times. People would come here to pray and contemplate. I found the herd. There goes the alpha leading the troop. And the rest of the clan follows. Males at the flanks protecting the little ones and the females. I hope I'm not deemed too much of a threat. Chest. And they don't mind mating in public. Salam. Gentlemen, bringing more tourists here. Well, it's morning here at Geech camp, as you can tell by my morning eyes. Gets quite chilly at night. Fortunately, I had two sleeping bags in my tent here, and long underwear and whatnot. Not a bad sleep. I woke up a couple times because of the altitude. But all in all, pleasant for one who likes to sleep in a tent. Let's go see what's brewing in the kitchen here. The food has been tremendous on this Simien Mountain trek. All treks take porters, cooks, guards, and guides. And let's see what they're doing. Hey, how are you doing? Salam.
Hello, salam.
Good morning. Yes. Open fire. Brewing that Ethiopian coffee, millet. Fantastic. Salam, good morning.
Good morning.
Yes. What's for breakfast today?
Pancakes.
Yeah. Oh, we love pancakes.
You like pancakes?
Love it, man. Thank you so much. The food has been tremendous. Okay. Well, we're about 20 minutes outside of Geech camp. Today's going to be a long one, 17 kilometers to Chenek by way of Inmet Koko Mountain, where we'll rise to 3,926 meters. The landscape here is dry as always, but with the interesting additive of palm trees and the odd creek running through it, and lots of cacti. Still have to navigate over some water here. Located here behind me is the summit of Inmet Koko. The word means men and women in the local dialect, and it's here where young couples would come to couple. It's also known as the happy place or the paradise place, and looking at some of the incredible peaks and rock formations off into the distance and to the Ethiopian lowlands, it's easy to see why it is held in such esteem by local peoples. It's a stunning 270 degree promontory with views, spectacular views on every angle. You only get here if you do the 4-day trek as opposed to the standard 3-day trek, so I highly recommend it. Sun has come out and the light and clarity is better than we've seen in a while. Say hi to camera, Arzano.
Ah.
Salam. I'm pretty ambitious with my shots, so I was walking down a steep, kind of rocky path and wiped out, dropped my camera, my wide-angle lens, clip-on lens went flying. That was almost the second time I lost it, and somehow one of these Ethiopian lads spotted and found it for me, so I'm very grateful for that. Although we're going to be staying at about the same altitude tonight, we'll have gone up about, 400 or 500 meters, then we got to go down about 600 meters and up another 800 meters in these 17 kilometers. So it's an exerting day approaching another valley and deep gorge. And I can see a little village and terraced fields way off in the distance. I've just come off the summit of Enati up here. Enati meaning mother in the local tongue at 4,070 meters. It's the highest point of our trek. It was a grueling hike all morning and early afternoon to get here under the hot African sun, but it was well worth it. I'm standing in front of some of the most stunning scenery anywhere on the planet here in the Ethiopian highlands. This gorge in front of me is, I'd say, at least 3 kilometers deep, if you can believe it. Just takes your breath away and makes you woozy. And over here to the north, the furthest point
that way is Ras Dashen, the tallest peak in Ethiopia at over 4,500 meters and one of the tallest on the continent. One last view of Enati as we start into the final approach to Chinek, known as the hard weather, or that's what it means.
Amazing.
Cold, hard weather. Let's hope it's not so. So we are on our descent into Chinek, and we're getting our first views of that camp on into the distance. Here we are, morning, day four, waking up outside Chinek camp. There was frost on the ground in the morning. It was a cold sleep. I also had a migraine headache. I knew I shouldn't have drank that Coca-Cola yesterday. Don't usually drink regular Coke, but these Ethiopian lads followed us for hours offering us Coca-Cola, and I just couldn't say no, so suffered up with a migraine. Anyhow, check it out. It's pretty incredible here. And oh yeah, we got the ibex. That's what I meant to say. Just on the cliff faces behind us. We'll zoom into a shot in a moment.
Ten months after this trek, war once again broke out in this ancient land, after regional elections were held in Tigray province in defiance of the federal government in Addis Ababa, and an Ethiopian military base in Tigray was taken by Tigrayan forces. This footage was taken in early 2020. Ethiopia was at peace and COVID unknown to the world. My thoughts and prayers go out to the people of Ethiopia and all who have suffered from pestilence and war. Remember, it's a blessing simply to trod this earth.